Ronnie Duncan with the Ronnie's Roundup. We're coming from Waterford. It's called the Lions Den. And joining me right now is the one, the only, Jeff Rowland. Been a Lions fan since that time when they won that championship, NFL, back in 1957.
Yes,
no
sir.
More Tobin Road. But you told me, you said, Ronnie, you're not the only one drinking the Kool-Aid.
No.
You're drinking the Kool-Aid, too.
I always drink the Kool-Aid, brother. Hey, I predicted them 12-4. And they went 12-4 that one year. I didn't buy a beer for a whole month. So there you go.
When you consider what's happening tonight, Jordan Love, no longer Aaron Rodgers with the Green Bay Packers.
Mm-hmm.
It's tonight, Thursday Night Football. How important of a win will this be for the Lions in their season? You've been a lifelong fan.
They are going to win again, okay? The last time it proved that they could win in Green Bay. So they're going to win in Green Bay again. I got faith, babe.
Now, the player of the week, Aiden Hutchinson. He's your guy. Tell me why.
U of M. I bleed blue, baby. I bleed blue. So, yeah, he's a good guy, and he's young, and he's going to go for it.
Good enough. Lions tonight, and, of course, we will have highlights if the game is over, but we're going to have some more fun. You know, when you speak of football or any sports for that matter, and you talk about households, unfortunately, black family households do not show up with the father. Many times, many of these athletes don't even have a father at the game. However, there are some brothers right there in Detroit who are trying to change all of that on the high school ranks, because they know being a father means being the leader of the house.
Yes, I'm very offended by it because, you know, in today's society, you know, we're stereotyped as being, you know, either incarcerated on drugs or a lower education.
Ivanos Davis loves watching his son Nikos play football. This is Nikos, who's the star quarterback at Liggett's High. But he wants to get rid of all of those stereotypes that say that black fathers are absentee from their children's lives.
It was more important than anything in the world, man, because I didn't get the opportunity to do that when I was growing up.
On the sideline, there's always the coaches. And for some of these fathers that I spoke to, they let me know there's always the dad.
To be in a position every day to be a father and a husband and to be there for both him and his brother, he has an older brother, Charles Jr., to play that role is just, I'm living a dream every day.
But I'm almost sure, in your short lifetime, someone has said, I wish your father was my father. Or they've said, I wish I had a father like your father. And I know you've heard, I don't even know who my father is, or he's not even a part of my life. When you hear all of that, tell me how the value of this relationship goes up.
It goes up a lot every time. It means a lot that he's my father, because I know a couple people that don't have a father, so him being my father just means a lot, and I'm very blessed.
You're very blessed, but so is Jeff Rowland, because you've got your wife, Colleen, almost 50 years. When did you know he was the right man, because he was what kind of a man?
He was a roast beef Lions fan man.
That means when she fixes that roast beef, that means the Lions win. I'm Ronnie Duncan, coming to you live from the place in Waterford called the Lions Den. Hey, 3, 2, 1, I'm done.